Hi guys, I'm back at Portsmouth wonderful Nevada store on behalf of Roland today, here to show you the wonderful SPD SX. Start off over here and show you the TD-9. Now, a lot of the guys that get the TD-9 tend to use just the preset kits, which are great, but the benefit of the TD-9KX2 is that I can save my sounds onto a key. So if I like one particular snare sound in that kit, I could save it as Craig 1, save it, put it in my pocket, and I could have thousands and thousands of kits in my pocket that I just load up onto the module, which is really powerful. I've got the new KD9 bass drum, which is a cloth bass drum. It's the first time we've done a cloth beater. And it'll take a double kick pedal without adjusting sensitivity settings, and it's absolutely solid as a rock. Really, really solid. Doesn't move anywhere. Really, really cool. Freeway rides. So if I go to my very first kit here, we have a jog wheel. Forgive me if none of you know anything about V-drums. I'm going to kind of give you a basic insight, if that's okay. Nice t-shirt, by the way. Very cool. So we have a V-drums kit. So all the sounds, they're all dual zone triggers, which means I can get two sounds out of each drum. So if I go from the middle or the head, I get the rim clips if I wanted to. We have over 500 sounds in the engine or the module that I can assign to any one of these zones at any one time. And I can hit and hold like a normal brass, bronze or alloy without having to grip on for dear life. We have three-way triggering on the right, the bell and the edge. It works really, 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 really nicely. And the whole thing is so dynamic. So if I'm playing a groove, you get really, really kind of cool dynamics. And wherever I play around the snare, every single note's heard. Now, I can really edit that kit beautifully. If I want to just edit it so it's not the sound for me, I can just press instrument and edit. And that is on my tuning page. So I can tune my snare or any one of my toms or my cymbals up. So for example, my cymbal here, I can take to a 1-inch. So a 1-inch crash, a 1-inch hi-hat. While the outer zone is still 40. Or if I wanted to, I can go to 40-inch, big mothers if you want those as well. So we'll go to ones. I can tune my snare, independent zones if I wanted to. There's my snare sound. And once again, I'll take the middle tone of the ride cymbal and tune it, and also decide how long I want the sustain to ring out for. It's cut off all the sustain while the other two zones are still ringing out. And we can take the bass drum again. Got that. And I could also then, if I wanted to detune it, I could do exactly the same. So I'm going for the 40-inch crashes here. Hi-hat. Sustain all rolled back on. I'm going to go for a massive sounding cymbal. As low as you want that kick to be, really. So if I take the tom-tom, this is a really cool thing. I can adjust the muffling, so how long I want that drum to ring out for. So for example, muffling is completely off. One bit of tape, two bits of tape, one bit of felt, two bits of felt. So we've cleared all the overtones completely. But if you want a bigger sounding kit, if I can go to the muffling off, go up to the head tuning, you can take it down 500 100-inch gong drum if you wanted it, basically. Change the room that I'm playing in, which really what helps with it with the EQ. So looking at your sound, so if I just press instrument then ambient EQ, I've got completely dry. Then I can change the room from a living room to a bathroom to a studio to a garage to a locker room to a theatre to a cave to a gymnasium to a dome. Now the dome is kind of cool. That's in a dome and you see there's not a lot of difference. Purely for the reason that the size of the dome is tiny. And on my screen, there's a really nice, attractive picture of a dome that gets bigger and bigger. So if I can do that, you know, I can hear it. You can hear it rattle around now. And then if I can change the actual material of the wall, so I can go from glass to plaster to wood. A bit extreme, but it makes a huge difference. Glass, the shape of the microphones on the kit, so I can have them up or down if I wanted to, and the actual size of the room itself. Start to mess around with the EQs, which is really cool. And if I like that, I could just press quick record and I could go right, okay. So you can constantly evaluate your own performance, which I always say if I'm teaching or performing at clinics, always record yourself, always listen back to your drumming, because how you perceive it when you're sat here playing to how you perceive it when you're sat there is completely different. Adrenaline is everything, obviously, and you'll find yourself starting off playing Celine Dion and ending up playing Slayer. So it's really important to always, oh, which is great, you know, but always really important to kind of listen back to your playing. So go through some of the kits, which are really cool. If I got something like a funky jazz, now, using some of the technology using the KD-9, you can hear that bass drum. Can you give a bit more, of this side for me? There we go, that's cool. So you can hear that overtone, that rumble of the bass drum. Now we have something here we call velocity switching, which means if I hit it harder, a bit more velocity, it will ask it to do something different. So in this instance, what we call drumming when we're playing felt beaters, we bury the beater into the bass drum, which obviously will kill the overtones. It's killed it, which is really cool. So great for jazz, mate. In that, burying that beater, it makes a huge difference to your playing as well. Some of the kits we can really use live. One of the kits that I designed, because I was doing lots of jungle and drum and bass stuff, was a jungle hi-hat. So now we have a hi-hat on the second pad, but what I can do is control it with the VH11. We can still play it. Two pads. Short release staccato. From there we can go into some of the other cool kits. Is we can play shuffle blues. We have a massive snare drum, 17 inch hi-hat, a And I'd like to go on to some of the kits that I kind of really like to use live, which make you think outside the box a little bit, really, is we have a double bass drum kit. So for you can normally tell because the metalers kind of look like metalers. So, but if you're learning to play, forgive the stereotype, obviously, if you're learning to play double bass drums, obviously I've got my double kicks here, and I always say to any drummers, try to learn double bass drums. I'm not saying going to go play and play extreme fugga dugga fugga dugga fugga dugga all night long, but the fact is it will open up your left side immensely. So we have two bass drums that I can obviously. But if we don't have double bass drum pedals yet, the TD-9 gives you hi-hat, but if you go to the double bass drum kit, it'll give you a bass drum on the hi-hat pedal. And I'm also playing here almost like a drop clutch hi-hat. So if I open my pedal, exactly the same, it doesn't open. So it's great. But this is the cool thing about practice, is if I go to the middle zone of the VH11, it's also a bass drum. So if you play in an extreme death metal band, where it's like double death metal, I don't know, death metal, you can do some quite interesting coordination patterns, either for your left side, or if you're just getting around the kit. Screw your bass player up as well, which is great fun as well. Or you can go to kind of more extreme kind of blast beat, really, if you want to play jazz, that sort of thing. Then into house and Latin percussion. Now this is great because you can use the dual triggers to maximum effect. If I just angle my toms up slightly so I can get a real perch on the sticks. Here, congas, timbali. You can do heel toe technique if you want to, either on the old the FD8 or on the VH11. So I can do. Kicking my heel away. It's like the crazy idea that there's more than one person playing or using two limbs. So I'll be normally doing that. Kits, we have a tabla and bubbles, which are really, really nice. If I go to F1 and press my editing screen, I can control the pitch of them on the fly. So if I'm going, triggers around you really works well, and if ever you get the gig with Prince. Tight hi-hats, and we also have brushes as well, so if I wanted to play jazz quite easily, I can go to one of the backing tracks. We have 50 backing tracks on the 9 that I can just play along to. I can speed up or slow it down. I'm struggling with that tune, I can drop a marker so it'll go over certain parts of that track. I'll just keep looping it, slow it down, take my piano player out and just jam along to a bass line, put a click to it. We have a visual metronome called the scope function, so it gives you horizontal and vertical lines, like a grid, and basically it'll give you a track to play along with, and you basically can try and play on that grid. And you can really see just how good or bad your timekeeping is, because you can zoom into one click or out to eighth notes if you wanted to, which is cool. So, to some of the other kits as well, I'd like to share this one with you, which is really, really cool. It's an old school hip hop kit. There are two snares, hand claps, cymbals. One. When I practice for the clinics that I do, wherever stage, in front of how many people worldwide, I always try and work on new concepts and ideas. Electronics, I'm biased obviously because of Roland, but electronics that have absolutely changed my playing irreversibly. So for example here, cymbal, we'll give you a note. Toms, so you got three notes. And the idea, what I try and do is I try and compose things when I'm playing. So I think, right, okay, three notes. Just play that on its own. It can be quite hard because your right hand would normally go crash tom tom. You'd never play that. So the idea, put a snare in. Thing, or even tabla. Electronica, world famous TR-808. Now, TR-808 has been used for over 20 years on more number one albums ever. This sound. Guaranteed to break every single speaker ever. TL9, so everyone used to dance and go to clubs in Deal when I was a kid. They'd come out dancing to Yaz constantly. And even voices.
Ding, 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 ding. Yeah.
So, just quirky ones, I can go to the tuning again, once again. So I'm going to leave you with this it's a Kraftwerk thing I've been remixing at the moment, which is really fun, so here you go. Ba 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 ba